Hello, what's up? Really quick, before the video actually starts, I want to explain to you guys that this is a first video of a three-part series, just because I have that much I want to share with you guys, and I know I'm so boring to listen to, so I didn't want to bore you guys to death in one long video, so I broke it up into three different parts, but I promise each video is very important, and please watch all three of them to get the full understanding of what I'm trying to say. Yeah, so enjoy the film. What's up, and thanks for coming to now my second video. If you haven't seen my first one, really quickly, who I am. I'm trying to do my best to do my part to kind of really make this world a better place to live in for everybody on it. So all my videos are going to be about how I'm doing that on a personal level, what my philosophy is, what my goals are, what I want to see, what I want to do moving forward, you know? So with that being said, my videos are going to be pretty informative, philosophical, mindsetting kind of videos, and what I'm doing on a personal level. So I'd like to share with you guys how I'm doing that. You guys don't have to follow and do everything I'm doing. I just want to show you how someone like me, just a random guy, is kind of doing it to the best that I can. You know, I'm obviously not by any means perfect. I'm simply applying what I'm learning to try to do the best that I can. And I want to share with those that are willing and open to also do their effort, to do their part. So I want to start off by saying on how I practice this loving, sustainable lifestyle on a personal level so that I don't have any hate or any negative feelings in my heart. You know, I don't hold any negative emotions in me, and sounds unrealistic. You know, obviously you might think I have to get mad about some things, but let me show you guys. Let me teach you guys how I do this. So first, I really understand the other person, you know, and this video is going to be about how I apply it on a personal level. So I don't get mad at other people that try to hurt me or try to offend me or try to disrespect me or insult me, whatever. That doesn't upset me. And the reason why is because I understand two things. I understand that this person isn't the way they are today by choice, 100% by choice. I understand that this person, you know, they were born and raised differently than I was. And I often say to myself, if I was born and raised the same way this person was, I would probably be doing the same thing. You know, that understanding is critical to remember, because then it explains why I shouldn't be getting mad. It explains why instead I should feel compassion for this person. Although they are committing a crime, although they have hate and frustration and anger in their heart and want to cause pain, I understand it isn't this person's fault that they are the way they are. And I say this because psychologists and psychoanalysts and, you know, like Freud and Skinner and Vygotsky and Yuri Bronfenbrenner and Albert Bandura, all these very science guys have shown us in their studies in the past that what you are exposed to since birth, the way you are born and raised and everything that you come into contact with, again, since birth, all the way up until however old you are, until adulthood, teenage years, late adulthood, every single thing that you have come into contact with, every single thing that you have experienced since birth has shaped you in some way. So this is really important to remember, because you didn't choose the family you wanted to be born into. You didn't choose your community that you were going to be born into. You didn't choose your neighborhood. As a kid, you didn't choose what schools you were going to be placed into. So a lot of what you experienced was not entirely up to you, right? And we have to remember that different settings, different places, different communities have a huge effect on who a person grows up to be on different levels. You know, if somebody's raised in this area, they're going to be different than somebody raised in this area. Somebody raised by an abusive household is going to be different than somebody raised in a very loving and affectionate household. You know, those adults are going to grow up differently. And we have to understand this. All too often, we forget about this or we don't know about this. That's why I'm kind of here sharing with you guys. Because you no longer get mad or upset at people. Why? Because you understand that possibly they are the way they are because of some traumatic events that they had growing up. Maybe the area they were born into was very aggressive, gun violence, whatever. That's a typical, but it really applies in every way. And we have to remember this because once you understand people, it makes it a lot easier to help them. And I say this like, let's say a toxic relationship. Let's say you're the normal one, right? The other person, like you start recognizing, oh, this person has some insecurities, whatever. Don't get mad that this person is jealous, or don't get mad that this person is, you know, radiating their toxicity into your relationship. Instead, take a step back and say, oh, okay, like this person was born and raised differently than I was. You know, I don't know what this person's been through to make this person be this way. Once you understand, you're not mad at them. Instead, you say, oh man, like, well, since I care about you, like, I want the best for you. How can we address this? So now you're not responding with, what the heck is your problem, blah, blah, blah. Now you're responding with, like, how was it growing up? You know, how were your previous relationships? You know, you kind of dig deeper. And that's where the healing process really has to take into effect. Because if you just yell back, slap them, break up with them, whatever, like, yeah, in this case, you should break up with them. But in another situation, you just send them to prison, whatever, but they still think this same way. They're still not thinking properly. And if we address that this is a community issue, let's just say, then that community is still sick. And other kids in that community are going to grow up the same way this person was. So it doesn't do you any good. It doesn't do anybody any good if we just respond on the surface level, get mad, whatever, cuss them out, whatever. That doesn't really create any real change. So that's why I ultimately try to understand first. One, because I don't get mad. You become almost unstoppable. You're untouchable. No matter what somebody says or does, you understand, like, you are the way you are because of the circumstances you went through. It's not your fault. I'm not going to blame you for it. I'm not going to punish you for it. I bet if I was born and raised the same way you were, I'd be doing the same thing. And really, this emphasis on why we have to understand, like I said, is because responding on a surface level, just getting mad at them, punching them back, whatever, that's not going to solve anything. That's not how change is created. You know, if you really want to start seeing change, you got to start radiating this understanding first. You got to show people what it looks like to not be mad, but instead what it looks like to dive into real solutions. And I will take it even a step further. Once you understand the person, I managed to still love the other person regardless of what they did, no matter how bad of a crime. You know, I would even go so far as to say I still love Donald Trump. I know. Well, chill. I know. Relax. Sounds crazy. I know. But watch my next video and you'll see what I mean. Thanks for watching this video. Watch the next one. Thank you.